This is the rare what happened to video where the guy's actually still in the NBA. The reason we haven't seen Delly though is actually mysterious. One report confirms a major problem, then the Cavs guard comes out and denies it, but now he looks like he might be done. This video explains what happened to Matthew Dellavedova, and while he's not a key player anymore, why it still matters. Yo, it's Casey Kiernan. This is AM Hoops. Stories and opinions so you can live your best NBA life. Two really important member shoutouts before we get to this feature Friday. First is Shane O'Keefe, who I am super grateful for, one of the OG members, like back when we only had Patreon. And the other is Usman Qureshi. Guys, thank you so much. So if you want a shout out, get in on our weekly live streams, the Discord server, click the join button below, and the PS5 giveaway comes April 2nd, just a few more days. On to the video, and every team needs a Matthew Dellavedova, a Deli, an Outback Jesus. Not afraid to make the dirty play, never showing up fully in the box score. But to understand exactly what happened to him, you have to know how he thinks, like an underdog. No one thought Delly could make the NBA. He's from Australia, both parents are athletes. He was even a star youth basketball player, but no big American schools wanted him. He went to St. Mary's. Look, if you know St. Mary's, then you really like college basketball. Delly, though, immediately became one of their best players. They made the Sweet 16 in 2010 with the Aussie hitting clutch free throws. 2 years later, he played in the Olympics against LeBron James, Kobe Bryant, and Team USA as a college kid. Dude held his own, too. So after all that, how did he go undrafted? People underestimated him, nothing new. But the way he stuck on the Cavaliers is how he thinks. Basically, he plays every game like it's his last, which is good and bad. First, the good. Cavs fans fell in love with Dellavedova during the 2015 finals. He started after Kyrie Irving broke his knee in game one. In game three, the underdog played lockdown defense against the Warriors with 20 points in 39 minutes. Now, all of a sudden, the scrappy Aussie kid no one believed in was sitting next to LeBron James answering questions in the finals. The next year, he won a ring and earned almost $40 million from Milwaukee. Oh, in the fights, dude loves to fight. Or maybe people like to fight him? Makes sense. Other NBA players voted him one of the dirtiest in the league. That led to multiple beefs with Marcus Smart, Al Horford, Bismack Biyombo. Why is it always gotta be big guys? So confident insanity was good for his legacy. It's how he got to the game, good for his bank account, but it was bad for his health. Delly went to the hospital after that finals game three we talked about with extreme dehydration and exhaustion. He also started racking up concussions. The first major issue was at the end of last year when he missed the final 17 games with a massive concussion. Then in the first preseason game this year, he fell hard in the third quarter.
Got bumped by Dellavedova. Dellavedova topples backwards.
His head bounces off the hardwood. It was such a bad concussion, he's missed months, but he didn't leave that game. Somehow, the Cavs trainers took a look at Delly and didn't take him out. I mean, he didn't look like himself, but he played almost the entire fourth. Look, I know athletes want to stay in games, especially Delly, but doctors should protect them from themselves. Look, the hit itself was bad enough, but considering Delly's concussion history, it is insane. It's easier for a person who's already had a concussion to get another one again, but he's really lucky that didn't happen later that game. There is a condition called repetitive head injury syndrome. From a study, quote, "Loss of consciousness is not a requirement of this condition. The impact may seem relatively mild, and the athlete may appear only dazed initially. However, the second impact causes cerebral edema and herniation, leading to collapse and death within minutes." Dellavedova could have died in a preseason game this season. that reality scared some people enough to say this: retirement is an option, if not likely, for Cavaliers' Matthew Dellavedova. That report goes on to say that even in February, he was experiencing concussion symptoms and could barely work out. And the big risk here is having life-threatening long-term effects. The most infamous example of this, of course, is from football. Many players suffering from CTE have killed themselves with extreme depression, confusion, and anger later in life. In fact, two-time Super Bowl champ Dave Duerson shot himself in the chest on purpose so his brain could be studied. Hall of Famer Junior Seau did the same thing. He was known as a wild, fearless player, just like Dellavedova, but was dead at 43 years old. So, it makes sense. Other people would say retirement is on the table, but Delly came out immediately and tweeted this: "Retirement is not on my mind at all right now. Only focus is getting healthy and back with the boys to make a playoff push." And I'm not surprised. Even in the face of serious long-term effects, that's the kind of guy he is. Even if he doesn't play for Cleveland, I know he's going to represent Australia in the Olympics. So after that tweet, as he was ramping up, Delly's appendix had to be taken out, and he rehabbed yet another injury. By the time you watch this, though, he may have played his first game for the Cavaliers. But honestly, I think he should retire. I know it's not in his DNA. The signs, though, are obvious that it's time. At some point, someone in his life has to step up, because he's never going to stop playing on his own. The reason he made the league was through that confident pit bull mentality. Dude thinks he can do anything, but the same thing that got him to the league could take him out for good. Luckily, Dellavedova has a great reputation in Cleveland, and the young players love him. Colin Sexton even said he's like a coach on the sideline and they need Dellavedova. When he does retire from playing, there will probably be a spot for him in the league. Let me know in the comments what you think. Am I overstepping my place here saying that he should retire? Or do you think, like me, the risk is way too much? Either way, dude has made millions of dollars, has a ring, and an awesome legacy. So guys, that is what happened to Matthew Dellavedova. We are all praying for him and hoping the best. For other Feature Fridays, we have the playlist linked above. And last week, a really inspirational story about Dwight Powell of the Mavericks.